everyone, welcome to my channel. This is Sonali Gupta and you are watching The Cryptonomist. I know this video has been pending for a long time, but due to some personal commitments, I was not able to upload this video. But nevertheless, here we are. Today, I want to talk about all Ethereum scaling solutions and compare them. What makes them different from each other? Which one's better? If you wish to invest or if you're eyeing these scaling solutions for your next investment portfolio, then you must watch this video because I am going to compare these solutions, their technologies, and which project should stand the test of time.
It's complicated, so pay attention.
So let's dive in. Ethereum scaling solutions are of four categories. These are Plasma, Rollups, Side Chains, and State Channels. I have also added the timestamps below so you can hop around to your favorite topic. But for this particular video, I suggest that you watch the whole way through. Let's start with the most popular scaling solution, which is Rollups. In Rollups, transactions are executed off-chain and their data or proof of transaction is posted on the main chain. This way, Rollups leverage the security of the main chain while offloading the transaction execution off-chain. There are two types of Rollups, ZK Rollups and Optimistic Rollups. These are the basic differences between ZK and Optimistic Rollups. ZK Rollups in general are faster and cheaper than Optimistic Rollups, but they may not be suitable for all type of dApps as validity proofs are intense to compute. Also, withdrawing funds from layer 2 to layer 1 is much faster in ZK Rollups. Now coming to the projects that implement ZK Rollups, these are Loopring, Hermes, ZK Tube and Diversify. Of these, Loopring and Diversify are the most popular and the fastest decentralized exchanges built on layer 2. Their transaction throughput ranges from 2000 to 9000 transactions per second compared to 15 of Ethereum. On how to use Loopring and Diversify, I have added links in the description box below. So you can simply connect your MetaMask wallet and swap tokens on these DEXs for very minute fees. On a side note, we will compare this with Polygon further in the video. As for projects using Optimistic Rollups, these are Optimism, Arbitrum, Truebit Protocol, Fuel Network and Cartesi. Of these projects, only Arbitrum and Truebit Protocol have been launched on the mainnet. Optimism should be launched soon. Both Arbitrum and Optimism do not have a token yet. They are quite similar with only one technical difference. Arbitrum, like Truebit Protocol, seeks to find a single point of disagreement between solvers and verifiers and then have it checked on the main chain. If you want to understand verification game further, you can watch my video here. For this reason, I believe Arbitrum and Truebit have a slight edge over Optimism. The difference between Arbitrum and Truebit is that Arbitrum is a consumer-facing product, meaning you and I can use it to trade and swap tokens through Uniswap. Truebit, on the other hand, is for developers and dApps to be developed on. Also, Truebit, like Polygon, which we will cover later in the video, also serves as an interoperable bridge between two different blockchains, which is an invaluable feature in the present times. Talking about their partnerships, Uniswap has already been deployed on Arbitrum, although they do plan to launch on Optimism as well after its mainnet launch. Optimism has also been backed by Synthetix, so Synthetix users will be able to use Optimism very soon. Coming to the next category of scaling solutions, it is Plasma chains. The main idea of Plasma is to make a framework like a blockchain tree of small blockchains called child chains or plasma chains and connect them to the main chain in a hierarchical order. The idea of plasma scaling was first introduced by Vitalik Buterin in 2017 and much iterations have been made over the years like Plasma Cash or Minimum Viable or More Viable Plasma. Both OMG Network and Polygon use their own iterations of Plasma. OMG Network has lost a lot of traction over time, while Polygon is the most talked about scaling solution on Ethereum. Polygon aims to be the hot suite of scaling solution and has bagged the most partnerships with the likes of Kyber, Aave, Zapper, SushiSwap, 1inch and many more. It has more than $7 billion logged on its platform. The issue with Plasma is that, like optimistic rollups, it takes a long time to withdraw funds from layer 2 to layer 1. And like ZK rollups, it is not possible to deploy general purpose smart contracts on it. Also, Plasma and sidechains are not as decentralized as we'd like. Polygon plans to launch optimistic and ZK rollups soon, but for now, only Matic Plasma and proof of stake sidechain are live on the mainnet. So let's discuss what sidechains are. Sidechains are basically blockchains that run parallelly with the main chain and have their own consensus mechanism. The problem with sidechains is that it is incredibly difficult for them to achieve decentralization. More often than not, the founding company ends up owning the majority of the whole platform. So even if it is highly unlikely, the validators could collude to commit fraud. So you have to trust the network that it will basically not run away with your money. As I said before, it is highly unlikely, but isn't trustlessness the whole point of blockchain? In Polygon's defense, they are developer focused and they have made the platform easiest to deploy EVM compatible smart contracts. They have more trading volume than Binance Smart Chain and the token has performed incredibly well in 2021. The team has noted community's concern and hopefully will work towards correcting or accommodating these drawbacks. Of course, there are smarter people than me working on these solutions, so I reserve the right to be pleasantly surprised. Talking about the next sidechain scaling solution, which is XDAI. XDAI has two tokens, which are XDAI, which is pegged against DAI, which is used to pay for transaction fees. And then there is Stake token, which is used to run and secure the network. I have not used XDAI personally, so do let me know in the comments below. How was your experience? The last of the sidechain scaling solution is Scale Network, which basically employs thousands of nodes to run small shard chains that sit on top of Ethereum's base layer. Scale Network does not have the kind of traction Polygon does, as it is, Ethereum layer 2 scaling solution has become a very competitive state. Before I move on to our last scaling solution, let's compare ZK rollup based Loopring and Diversify with Plasma and sidechain based Polygon. As a user, if you wish to access DeFi platforms like Aave and you wish to save on those gas fees on layer 2, then you can use Polygon, but you must be careful as even though a two-third attack is unlikely, it is still possible even if just on paper. So keep yourself updated with Polygon news. I don't wish to spread FUD, but you should keep yourself updated with Polygon news. If you just wish to swap tokens, then you can use Loopring and Diversify, which is much more secure. The last of our scaling solution is State Channels. State Channels is a mechanism where two parties lock their funds in a contract and have any number of transactions between them while transacting only twice on the main chain. That is, once when they enter in the contract and once when they exit. The most popular state channel solution is Raiden Network. Some features of Raiden Network are live on the mainnet and some are still in the development phase. The volume on Raiden Network is not much to boast about though. As for investment advice, I am not fully equipped to give you one, but in my personal experience, I like to invest in projects that have strong fundamentals and a network effect. Network effect is when a lot of people start to use the network. Out of all the projects that I covered in this video, Polygon seems to have the best network effect, but lacks in being truly decentralized. TruBit Protocol and Arbitrum have the best fundamentals, but are very new, so they lack the network effect. Loopring and Diversify employ the best scaling solution, which is ZK rollups, but they can't be used for general purpose smart contracts. Whatever scaling solution you may use, it seems some trade-offs are imminent. Well, I hope I was able to clear the cloud on these many scaling solutions. If you liked my video, do press the like button, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you're the first to watch my next upload. This is all from me today. Hope you guys have a great day. I will see you in my next video where I talk about DeFi platforms like Aave, Compound and Maker.